Turns out that you need at least 12 gigabytes of space. Oops, I was using 8 gig USBs. Good learning curve. Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. Are you into home labbing? My name's Ash, I'm a cybersecurity enthusiast, and on today's video, I'm beginning my home labbing journey. So let's start off with what home labbing is. Home labbing comes in many forms: computers, systems, infrastructure at home to create whatever you want. Maybe you want to test Windows Server, Ubuntu Server. Maybe you want to set up a media server, or maybe you want to test infrastructure that you use in the workplace at home. It's kind of endless, and I think it's a great way to continue learning networking fundamentals. So let's get into it. So my home lab is starting with my wife's old laptop. One, it's not being used anymore and it's just gaining dust. It's learned power consumption is a great option. It's a really small form factor in it. It's got enough power to run everything, which I'm going to be calling non-critical services. Media server, downloading server that aren't crucial to the network. So what next? An operating system. Now, there's a wide variety of that we can pick from. My goal with this home lab is to keep it as simple as possible. Lean, mean. So I went with a classic Ubuntu Linux distro. It's lightweight, it's completely free, I'm familiar with it, so it's a pretty good option for me. So the first thing is to head over to Ubuntu's website, download the ISO. For me, it was really slow, took like nearly 2 hours, so bad. Once it's downloaded, we're gonna go ahead and create a bootable USB using Rufus. Learn from me, be a bit more patient. This process can take a little bit longer than expected. I ended up just being impatient, stopping the USB, and it basically bricked it. So that was one USB. Then went over to the next USB, that failed, and then I actually looked up the minimum requirements. Turns out that you need at least 12 gigabytes of space. Oops, I was using 8 gig USBs. Good learning curve. Found my 32 gig USB, formatted that using Rufus, and I was patient this time, and then there was no worries. And then setting up Ubuntu was really easy. I did make one mistake, I didn't actually wipe the drive of the Windows operating system. So after the default process, which honestly didn't take that long, then it was over to remote access. My server's like tucked away in a cabinet near our modem router. If I want to make any changes, I'm not going to go over and unplug it and bring it out here. So Ubuntu actually makes it pretty easy just to turn remote desktop on, like in the settings in the GUI. With RDP or VNC enabled, I can go ahead and use the remote desktop on Windows, and it's okay. It's pretty workable. You can log in and it works. I did run into the first issue: what happens when the system locks? So I had to find an alternative. After a bit of research, the alternative is XRDP. It was super simple and it works. It initializes before the user is logged in, therefore it's running from system startup. Great, that's exactly what I need. So did a final reboot to test, and now it's 100% remote. So there was another problem. Maybe it's not a big problem for anyone, but I like some sort of adaptive resolution. I like to be able to have my Windows resize, which the default app in Windows doesn't do. So I did a bit of searching until I stumbled across RDP tool from Microsoft, but just over the Microsoft store. So gave it a go and it works great. I was kind of surprised. For a little bit of fun, I thought that I would try running an nmap scan to see what I can actually see on that device. And all that I can see is one port open, 3389, which is RDP, which is great. So there's no other ports that are accessible, even though that's just locally on my network. I do have a few plans. I want to set up Docker, is to just containerize my applications. So there's a lot to learn, and that's a lot of the fun of having your own home lab. Honestly, it's just like a technical playground where you can sort of do whatever you want. So now this is probably the most simple form of the home lab that it's going to be. It's just one device. It's just an old laptop. It's really that easy. Anyone can get this set up. So if you're thinking about setting up your own home lab or something, it doesn't have to be complicated. So if you're interested in following the journey, the plan is to record what we can and share it with you guys as we progress through. And to keep security focused as I go through and build this lab, in the meantime, check out my latest TryHackMe walkthrough, which is called Source. So go check that right up and I will see you in the next one.